Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're going to look at one of the methods to find a determinant of a 3x3 matrix. The first method we're going to look at is called expansion by minors. So what that means is we're going to expand using the equation with minor matrices. So you need to know how to find the determinant of a 2x2 matrix first before you start with a 3x3. Okay, so here's our example. We have the matrix A, and we're going to look at the elements. A, B, C is the first row, D, E, F is the second row, and G, H, I is the third row. So to find the determinant, and this little absolute value bars over the determinant actually, or over the matrix name actually means the determinant. So find the determinant. We're going to take A, which is my first entry, times E times I minus F times H. Well, if you take out this column in this row that A is in, we have a 2x2 matrix. And this part of the formula actually represents the 2x2's determinant. Then what we're going to do is move to the second position. We're going to now subtract, and notice it's minus B. So we're going to take B as the coefficient. We're going to take out the top row again, but we're going to take out the column B is in, and what we're left with is D, F, G, I. That creates another 2x2 determinant, or two by two matrix. We then find the determinant. So I take D times I minus F times G, and that's where the second part of the formula comes from. And then for the third one, we're going to look at C. Now we're going to add plus. So we're going to add C. C is the third entry in our matrix in the first row. And if I take out that row in that column, I'm left with this 2x2 matrix. We then find the determinant by taking D times H minus E times G. And that is the last portion. So that is how you find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix using minors. Now, it looks complicated, but once you try it a couple times, it's actually pretty easy. I tell my students to concentrate on A minus B plus C. Kind of know your coefficients, then you just cross out the rows and columns and they can see the 2x2 matrix. So let's try one. So let's see. A, B, and C in this one are that top row. So A is 2, B is negative 1, and C is 3. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write A parentheses minus B parentheses plus C parentheses. And in the parentheses, I'm going to write my formula for my 2x2 matrix. So let's start off by plugging in values. So let's see, A is, whoops, 2. B is negative 1. So I've got minus a negative 1. So I've got a double negative I'm going to end up adding there. Plus C, which is positive 3. Now let's go back in here and let's fill in our 2x2 matrix. So A, I'm going to take out this row and this column, or this row and this column, and I'm going to find the determinant for this 2x2. So I'm going to multiply 0 times 4, and that's 0, minus 2 times 1, which is 2. Okay, there's the first step. Then I'm going to move. Well, let me erase my 2x2, my product here. And I'm going to move over and whoops, I'm going to look at B. Okay, so B is negative 1. So I'm going to keep that same row slashed out. And the column now I'm taking out is B's column. And so I'm left with the 2x2, which is negative 2, 1, 1, 4. So let's multiply negative 8. And then the other product is minus, in this case, 1. Oh, let me bring it down here. Sorry. So negative 8 minus 1. That's my second determinant. And let's move this column over. Yet a third time for C. Oops. And there's my two matrix I can see now. Here's the negative 2, 0, 1, 2. So let's find the determinant of this one. That's negative 4 minus 0 times 1. Well, that's 0. So this ends up just being negative 4. And I can simplify this. Now I just have to use the order of operations. So I've got 2 times negative 2, which is negative 4. The double negative here becomes a positive. So I've just got 1 times 8 minus 1, which is negative 9. And then I've got 3 times negative 4, which is negative 12. So once I add all those together, I get negative 4 minus 9 is negative 13 minus 12. That gives me a negative 25. And that is the value of the determinant for this 3x3 matrix using expansion by minors. Hope this video was helpful.